Coming up on Bear News.
UNC has announced a special guest performing at the spring concert. Stay tuned.
Not feeling safe when purchasing things off Craigslist? We got you. Stay tuned to find out more about the safe transaction zones on campus.
Please be safe out there. There's a lot of frauds going on.
Cowtown Greeley, we have all the details coming up about the annual Colorado Farm Show.
Stay tuned and take a seat because more stories are coming on today's show.
Bear News starts now. Good afternoon, Bears. Happy Friday. I'm your host, Sophia Tavanello, and this is Bear News. Before we get started, I'd like to introduce you to Gabby Lopez, my co-host for today's show. Gabby, how are you doing?
I'm good. How are you, Sophia?
I'm doing fantastic. Thank you for joining me today.
Thank you for having me. I'm super excited.
I know. I'm not so lonely up here.
I know. We'll see how it goes, though. Take it away, Sophia.
Let's do it. Today, we'll be covering many events surrounding UNC, some Greeley updates, and some small throwbacks. Look out, Bears. You might see some more Bears appearing on campus this semester as Destination UNC starts this weekend. Destination UNC is a free, one-of-a-kind campus experience specifically designed for admitted students and their families. With a warm welcome from university speakers to attending afternoon breakout sessions, students will be able to customize their day to what they're interested in on campus. Students can choose from activities like information fairs, visits with professors and departments, and a free swag station. We look forward to welcoming these new students to Bear Country.
Have you heard of the new student group Shenanigans? Are you interested in watching a theater production? This student group is putting on an experimental show called Inner Life Change Cycle. The play was written by UNC professor Randall Harmon and his wife Barb Harmon. The show will perform tomorrow, Saturday, January 27th. There will be two show times, one at 6:30 p.m. and one at 8 p.m. in Gunter Hall. The show is free to attend. If you can't attend the performance, don't worry. We'll let you know how it went next week, so stay tuned.
Are you interested in learning more about safe sex and how disabilities can impact sexual health? Well, a sex positivity event on February 8th is happening. There will be discussions of how medications affect sexual health, how to protect yourself physically and mentally, and consent. There will be an anonymous Q&A for participants to ask questions about anything related to sexual health or overall wellness.
I'm super excited because we have been planning an event with the Office of Health Promotion. We're calling it Sex Positivity, and it's gonna be a conversation about the intersection of disability and sex. So if you want to learn more about that, please, please come to our event. We've got snacks, goodies, giveaways, and it should be a really good time.
The event will start at 4 p.m. in the University Columns in Columbine B. You can also join virtually if you're unable to attend in person. The link will be available in the next couple of weeks, so keep an eye out on the DRC and the OHP Instagrams.
Up next, our very own anchor, Sophia here, has a fun story to cover.
People tend to turn New Year's resolutions into long-term and short-term goals. A UNC student has taken a new step this year. This student and her family have now taken on making 10,000 paper cranes by the end of this year. She, however, has now turned this into something personal by making 1,000 for herself.
Gabby Reese, a junior studying sports and exercise science, wants to make cranes for herself, but still contribute to the 10,000 paper crane goal. However, she's been running into some small setbacks.
After I complete my goal of making 1,000 of these paper cranes, I'd love to hang them up on my wall, but it's a little hard with these guys tearing every single one down.
Gabby is also planning on giving paper cranes out to people she encounters on campus. She wants to spread some joy. She also has her brother to thank for this new hobby.
This was initially my brother's goal to make 10,000 paper cranes, but I thought that was absolutely insane to make 10,000 cranes all by yourself, so I decided to help. When he taught me how to make paper cranes at first, I wasn't so great, but now I think I'm a little better than him.
Gabby hopes to accomplish her goal of making 1,000 paper cranes by her birthday in April. Her family hopes to accomplish their goal of 10,000 by the end of this year. However, that might seem to be an issue with these little ones at home.
That's such a sweet resolution. I hope I get a paper crane. It's amazing how you can transport yourself so fast, Sophia.
I know, a magician never reveals their secrets.
I wish I was you.
We'll have more on the story later this semester.
During last night's basketball game, the University of Northern Colorado announced that Ice Spice will be headlining the school's spring concert. An Instagram post by the University Program Council created excitement and questions from students. But since that post went up, iSpy's potential appearance has come into question. There seems to be some inconsistencies surrounding the performance, leading our team to have some reservations. At this point, Bear News has reached out to iSpy's manager, but we haven't heard back. We'll keep you updated as the situation develops.
Up next, we have Sam with the weather.
Thanks, guys. Well, we're in this nice warming trend right now, and even across Greeley, we're experiencing mostly cloudy skies and temperatures around in the upper 40s. 40 down in Denver, though, as they were dealing with some snow early this morning, and 47 in Fort Collins right now, but we haven't reached our highs just yet, as we're supposed to warm up just a little bit more today, as I'll show you those forecasted highs. 49 in Greeley today, and 45 down in Denver, and 48 over in Burlington. But warm weather still on its way, as I'll show you our highs for tomorrow. It's going to be really sunny tomorrow, so get outside and enjoy those 50 degrees weather in Greeley and 49 up in Fort Collins. But if you do have plans to go out tonight, I got that planner covered for you right here, as this afternoon we'll be in the upper 40s, and as we move into tonight, it'll start to clear up and temperatures will dip down into the 30s. So if you got plans going out tonight, please dress accordingly and wear a coat. But that warm weather is on its way, as I'll show you that 7-day forecast. Dang, look at Sunday, 57 degrees and sunny, but look at all this sun coming our way, and temperatures up in the upper 50s all into next week, and even 60 degrees on Saturday. But I am tracking something coming later next weekend, but for now, enjoy that sunshine.
Thanks, Sam. Coming up after the break, we have Nathan Kitchen with sports. We'll be right back.
For decades, I've taught you everything I know. How to safely build a fire. How to control the flames. What to do with hot coals. How to secure your chains. But I can only teach wildfire prevention. Only you can prevent wildfires.
Last Saturday, the UNC women's basketball team traveled to play Portland State for their fourth Big Sky Conference game. The Bears control most of the game, keeping the Vikings under 60 points. The Bears beat the Vikings with a final score of 71-54. Sophomore Anaya Hall led the scoring with 24 points just off the bench. Senior Delaney Byrne added on the scoring with 17 points. Redshirt junior Seneca Hackley followed with 10 points. And Hannah Samatall rounded off the scoring with 9 points. The Bears will host Eastern Washington at 6 p.m. Thursday at the Bank of Colorado Arena. The UNC men's basketball team battled it out against Portland State at home this past weekend. The Bears had a strong second half against the Vikings, outscoring them 54-22. The Bears won against the Vikings 90-61. Junior St. Thomas once again led the scoring for the Bears with 20 points. Junior DeJour Reeves followed with 15 points. Graduate student Riley Abercrombie came in with 13 points. And sophomore Brock Wisney joined in the party with 11 points.
They elevated us even more, and that was awesome. So I've heard like we had a 40-8 run, a 28-0 run, like just all these crazy stats, which that doesn't happen very often, especially against a good team, especially when you're losing. So
the Bears will travel to play Eastern Washington at 7 p.m. at Reese Court. On the wrestling mat, the Bears traveled to North Dakota to take on the Bisons. The Bears ultimately fell 14-27 against those Bisons. Number 5 ranked Steve O'Poulin earned a technical foul to start off the match. Newly ranked number 18 Dominic Serrano earned a 5-1 decision to keep the momentum going. But the Bisons then rattled off 4 straight victories against the Bears. Even though Travis Mastriani managed to cut the lead with a 4-0 victory, unfortunately, it still wasn't enough. The Bears will be at home this Saturday to wrestle against Wyoming at 6 p.m. at the Bank Colorado Arena. Hope to see you there, Bears. For sports news around UNC, we want to congratulate senior Hannah Semitol and junior St. Thomas for both winning the Big Sky Player of the Week. Great to represent Bears country there. It was reported by the Greeley Tribune this week that UNC baseball is launching a $1.5 million fundraiser for turf at Jackson Field. There will be more to come in the following weeks for this story. That's it for sports this week, Bears. I'm Nathan Kitchen with Bear News Sports. Back to you, Gabby.
Thanks, Nathan. Next up, we have reporter Drew Peters with a fun Greeley update. Take a look.
We've all heard Greeley referred to as a cow town at some point. Maybe some of us have even joined in on the name calling. But why is being a city based in agriculture such a bad thing? Well, the annual Colorado Farm Show at Island Grove Park demonstrates just how valuable agriculture is to not only Greeley, but Colorado as a whole.
It has an exponential impact on Greeley when you think about what an event like the Farm Show does for agriculture in general and what agriculture does for Greeley.
For the past 60 years, the Farm Show has provided agricultural workers and enthusiasts a space to learn about the latest equipment and methods being used.
Core of it is education. We have not only the exhibitors here showing the latest and greatest equipment or about the latest and greatest soil health, water efficiency methods, those types of things, just kind of all things education out here with the exhibitors, but also we have classrooms going around the entire time that we're here.
Being free and open to the public, the show also gives residents an opportunity to see things like massive tractors up close.
We've never been out here before, and we are just coming out to explore things and celebrate her birthday. She's 2 today. And climb on farm equipment.
The Farm Show also gives Greeley a substantial economic boost during the 3 days it's in town.
And even just with that, with the folks who come from outside of Greeley and maybe even Weld County, it was upwards of about $2.5 million economic impact. And we think it's even probably bigger than that based on how many folks, you know, close by still come to downtown Greeley or, you know, still come to take part in the event. So
while this year's event has come to an end, we can expect to see the Colorado Farm Show continue to make an impact on the Greeley community in the years to come. I'm Drew Peters with Bear News.
Thanks, Drew. That's definitely good information to know.
The UNC Police Department recently created a safe transaction zone. The zone is located outside the UNC Police Building. The purpose of the zone is to make students feel more comfortable and confident when exchanging or selling items online. The safe transaction zone is under surveillance at all times, but you have to be careful with red flag sellers. UNC Police Officer Bobby Gallegos tells us more about these red flag sellers.
They're asking for money in advance. That's going to be a red flag there. Most of the time, if it's a legit transaction, they're going to want to meet you in person. So one of the things to look out is if they want money in advance before they meet you, don't do that. Don't give any credit card information. Don't give any bank information. Those could be big red flags as well.
If you're unable to meet in person at a safe transaction zone, one of the safest things you can do is meet at a public place.
Please be safe out there. There's a lot of frauds going on. So again, if you are gonna buy an object or an item online, make sure you're not prepaying for it. Make sure you're not meeting them at their residence or your residence. Just make sure you're using a safe transaction zone.
Don't forget to use a safe transaction zone the next time you buy something off an online marketplace or Craigslist.
Last week, online game portal Cool Math Games announced that the popular game Pop Tropical will be officially moving onto its site. Rumors began swirling in December 2023 about Pop Tropica's potential shutdown. But on January 18th, Cool Math Games took to X, confirming that the game, which has been around since 2007, will not be disappearing. According to the site, old players will still be able to access their accounts, but the membership system is being removed. Although Cool Math Games say Pop Tropica won't be receiving any new islands anytime soon, players can still enjoy old favorite like Mythology Island and Time Tangle Island.
That's it for our show, Bears, for this week. I'm Sophia Tavanello.
I'm Gabby Lopez.
Thank you for joining us today. Have a great weekend.